Nitai pada kamala koti chandra susitala. पावन श्री श्री नित्यानंद प्रभु की जय। जय पति पावन परम कारण प्रेम प्रदाता निताई की जय। जय जय परम कारण प्रेम प्रदाता पति पावन नित्यानंद प्रभु की शुभाविर्भावती थी की। नित्यानंद प्रभु की शुभाविर्भावती थी महामहोत्सव की। नित्यानंदाय नमः। So yesterday we observe the holy appearance day of supremely merciful Lord Sri Nityananda Nitai. We glorified Nitai something yesterday, just little. His glory is unlimited, ananta, because he is ananta naga, isn't it? Ananta deva, ananta. How we can glorify? We have no qualification. By his mercy, only one can glorify him, otherwise nobody can glorify him. By his own merit, scholarship, intelligence, strength, cannot do. His mercy is required. Today also, we are continuing that glorification, begging for the mercy of supreme merciful Lord Nityananda, Nitai More Karadaya. So we are reading some of his nectarian pastimes. Yesterday we read about his boyhood pastimes. Today we'll read the rest of his pastimes, some of the rest of his pastimes. His pastimes in Navadip Dham. Glorify more and more. I offer such prayer on this auspicious occasion.
Developed great love and affection for Nityananda Prabhu. Acting like a baby at this time, Nityananda was not eating food with his own hand.
Wonderful pastime, huh? Baby.
Yeah. Srivas's wife, Malini Devi, was feeding Nityananda Prabhu like her own son. One day, Srivas Pandit and Nityananda Prabhu were talking Krishna Katha. At that time, Mahaprabhu came there. Mahaprabhu wanted to test the love and affection Srivas had for Nityananda Prabhu. Mahaprabhu said, "Srivas, this Nityananda is an avadhut. No one knows what his kula or gotra, his family or caste. It is uncertain. Why have you kept such an avadhut in your house? All of your kula gotra will be polluted and destroyed. You should immediately drive him out."
Testing, testing, yes.
This was Mahaprabhu's test. Srivas said, Madhuri Yavani Yadi, Nityananda Dari, Jati Pranadana Yadi, Mora Nashikari, Tatapi Mahora Chite, Naika Anyanta, Satya Satya Tomare, Kahilun Ekata. Srivas Pandit had strong attachment and affection for Nityananda. He said, Madhuri Yavani, Madhura means drunkard. Yavani is a female gender for Yavana, a low-class person who generally eats meat. Madhira Yavani Yadi Nityananda Dari, Jati Pranadana Yadi Mora Nashakari. Even if a Madhira Yavani, a drunken low-class lady Yavana, comes and catches hold of Nityananda while he's staying in my house, thus polluting and destroying all my caste, my gotra, my life and soul, everything, still, I won't give up Nityananda.
So stronger God. Yes, whatever. Yes.
Then Srivas Pandit said, what I have said, this is satya, satya, satya. This is the truth. This is the truth. This is the truth. Srivas said this three times. Seeing the love that Srivas Pandit had for Nityananda Prabhu, Mahaprabhu became very pleased. Hearing Srivas' words, Mahaprabhu roared, Oh Srivas, you have such unquenchable.
Yeah. Roaring.
Oh Srivas, you have such unflinching faith in Nityananda. How do you know my Nityananda? He is very, very confidential. How do you know him? I am very much pleased with you. One day, Sachi Mata had a dream. She told her son, Vishvambar, Lord Chaitanya, about it. She said, Vishvambar, in a dream I saw you and Nityananda. You were both five-year-old boys, and you were wandering around my house. Your complexion was Shyam, black, and Nithai's was Gora, whitish. She saw them as Krishna and Balaram. Both of you entered into the deity room, where our deities of Balaram and Krishna are. You caught hold of those two deities. You held the Balaram deity. Nithai caught hold of Krishna, and you were manifesting many amazing leelas. Sometimes amongst yourselves you were quarreling. In the dream, Nityananda was calling me, Mother, I'm very hungry. Give me food, I want to eat. When Mahaprabhu heard this, he said, Mother, you had a very nice, auspicious dream. Please don't tell it to anybody. Keep it confidential to yourself. Mahaprabhu said, In the dream, Nityananda Prabhu said he wanted something to eat. So you must prepare a nice meal and invite Nityananda Prabhu today. Sachi Mata prepared a very nice, palatable meal, then went and invited Nityananda Prabhu. Vishvambar, Lord Chaitanya, and Nityananda washed their hands and feet and then sat down together. Sachi Mata was serving them. It was a very beautiful scene, just like in Treta Yuga, when Kaushalya was serving Ram and Lakshman. Sachi Mata was serving them, and the two brothers were eating. Don't worry, I'll get it back. Then he ordered, Hey, crow, immediately go and bring back the ghee pot. Immediately the crow went, brought back the ghee pot, and put it there in the courtyard. Malini Devi was amazed, seeing the wonderful influence of Nityananda Prabhu. She said, Oh, Nityananda, are you not the same person who in Dwarpar Yuga brought back the dead sons of your guru?
From Jama Jagor, yes. Not same person, yeah.
Are you not that same unlimited Ananta Sesh, whom the whole world rests upon one of the hoods like a mustard seed? In Treta Yuga, were you not Lakshman? In that incarnation, you entered so much service to Sita Devi. You killed the unconquerable demon Indrajit. So is it wonderful that you have brought back this ghee pot? When Nityananda Prabhu heard all of his glories, he ignored them and said, Mother, Mother, I want to suck your breast. Malini Devi then took Nityananda on her lap and he sucked her breast. This is the inconceivable leela of Nityananda.
Padita Pavana Paramakaruna Premadasa Nitai Ki.
One day, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was sitting with his wife, Lakshmi Priya, inside the house. Lakshmi Priya was offering betel nut to her husband. At that time, Nityananda Prabhu, being intoxicated with Krishna Prem, entered there naked. He is an avadut, a mad fellow. Mahaprabhu saw that Nityananda was naked. He said, "Oh Nityananda, why are you naked? Put on some cloth." Mahaprabhu took off his chadar and put it on him. Observing this wonderful leela, Sachi Mata was laughing. At this time, she was thinking of Nityananda as her eldest son, Vishvarup. One day, Sachi Mata gave 5 pieces of sandesh to Nityananda to eat. Nityananda ate one and threw the other 4 out. Sachi Mata said, "What did you do? You threw out the sandesh. What will you eat?" Nityananda Prabhu said, "Mother, why did you give them all to me at once?" Sachi Mata said, "Now there is no sandesh in the house. What will you eat?" Nityananda Prabhu said, "You can go into the kitchen and see. There may be some there." Sachi Mata went into the kitchen and saw the same 4 pieces of sandesh lying there. Sachi Mata was bewildered, thinking, "How did the sandesh get into the house?" Nityananda threw it over the boundary wall outside. Sachi Mata brought the sandesh to Nityananda Prabhu again. When she arrived, she was startled to see Nityananda Prabhu sitting there eating a sandesh. "How is this?" she thought. "I just brought these and he's already eating?" Sachi Mata asked, "Nityananda, where did you find this sandesh?" Nityananda said, "Mother, I had put it away. When he became aggrieved, I got it back." Seeing this Adbhuta Leela, this wonderful pastime, Sachi Mata said, "I cannot recognize you. Who are you? Why are you cheating me? Who are you? Tell me. I cannot understand or recognize you." Then Nityananda Prabhu became like a child and said, "Mother, I'm hungry, I'm hungry," and ran to touch the feet of Sachi Mata. This is a wonderful pastime of Lord Nityananda. One day, Nityananda Prabhu was acting like a small naked child, laughing with tears of love coming from his eyes. He was sometimes roaring, sometimes jumping, sometimes dancing. In this condition, he entered into the room where Mahaprabhu was sitting. Mahaprabhu saw that Nityananda Prabhu was naked. Immediately, Mahaprabhu took off his turban cloth and put it on Nityananda Prabhu. Then Mahaprabhu brought nice sandalwood paste and smeared it on the body of Nityananda Prabhu. He took a flower garland and put it around Nityananda Prabhu's neck. Making him sit down on an opulent singhasan, Mahaprabhu then began to offer him prayers. Nami Nityananda Tumi Rupi Nityananda E Tumi Nityananda Rama Murti Mantra. Your name, Nityananda, is full of eternal bliss, Nityananda. Your beautiful form is Nityananda, full of eternal bliss. Thus you are Nityananda Ram. Then Mahaprabhu begged a piece of copan from Nityananda Prabhu. He tore it into small pieces and distributed it amongst the devotees. Mahaprabhu told them, "All of you, put this piece of copan on your heads. Take it and offer worship to it in your house. By so doing, you will definitely get Krishna Bhakti." Then Mahaprabhu told all the devotees to take the foot-washing water of Nityananda and drink it. On the order of Mahaprabhu, all the devotees drank Lord Nityananda's Charanamrita. By so doing, they all felt supreme happiness. These two brothers, Nittai and Gour, intoxicated by Krishna Prem, like madmen, danced and chanted, "Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare."
Gour Nitai Ki
Jai!
Parama Karuna Gour Nitai Ki
Jai!
Sembata Nitai Ki
Jai!
Padita Pavana Maha Karuna Maya Premdata Nitai Ki
Jai!
Wonderful. first time saw Nityananda. Madhavananda Prabhu has put an article here in this Krishna. Sri Krishna Kadhamato, Nityananda Prabhu's so wonderful pastimes from Chaitanya Bhagavata, Srila Vrindavana Thakur, Lord Nityananda and the gang of thieves. Very wonderful pastimes. So we'll read it from this Chaitanya Bhagavata, Nitya Lila. It's a wonderful pastime of Nityananda. Patita Dhara, Patita Pavana Nityananda Prabhu. Choro dasyo dhama po tita nano jaro.
In Navadweep lived a Brahmin's son who had no peer among the thieves. He was a Brahmin in name only. His heart was filled with evil. He was a commander of an army of thieves. There was no mercy in his body. He always happily stayed among the thieves. Seeing Lord Nityananda's ornaments and his glistening necklaces of gold.
You have no. This translation of this.
I think I do.
Then you read that. Charo dasyu adhama patita nama jaro nama te nityananda koilu dharo. Nityananda delivered the thieves, the robbers, the dacoits, most degraded thieves, dacoits, various ways Nityananda Prabhu is merciful, he delivered them. Now this is an episode here in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, how he delivered such thieves, dacoits. Nityananda Sri Angara Alankara Paranatho Utta Dasyu Dalapati Nityananda Sangye Anukhyan Brahma Nityananda Sarupero Dekhi Alankara
Nityananda saved the most fallen. In Navadweep lived a young Brahmin who was actually a big rogue and dacoit. Although born in a Brahmin family, he was an arsenal of all depraved habits and was the leader of the dacoits. He was brutally malicious and killed without feeling. He was always in the company of rogues. Once his dacoit leader saw Lord Nityananda bedecked with all the fineries and priceless jewels and gloated after this treasure, wanting to steal it all. So pretending to be a member of the Lord's Sankirtan party, the dacoit went along with the chanting party wherever they went. He was biding time for the right opportunity to steal everything. Lord Nityananda immediately knew his wicked intentions.
Antare parama dusto nijo bhalo no
antare parama dusto nijo bhalo no
janile no Nityananda antare
Nityananda,
say. great translator.
The Lord, learning of his wicked desire, left the party and went quietly to live in Hiranya Pandit's house. Hiranya Pandit was a very pious Brahmin and lived frugally, becoming of a true Brahmin. In the meantime, the dacoit leader called his men and chalked out a plan. He said, "My brothers, why should we worry any longer?"
Wait. Say dusta brahmana parama dusta mati.
Meanwhile, the evil-minded Brahmin thief met with the other thieves and told them his plan. Oh, my brothers, why should we be unhappy any longer? Mother Durga has brought a great treasure house of wealth to a place nearby. On the limbs of the Avadhut Nityananda, are many ornaments of gold, pearls, and diamonds. There is nothing like these ornaments. What is the monetary value of all these ornaments? I do not know. Goddess Chandi has put them all in one place. Now they're all in Hiranya's house. In half an hour, we will rob them all. Taking our swords and shields tonight, we will go there and attack. Agreeing on this plan, the thieves met that night.
Yes.
Hana churi krisu lolo Iya jane jane
Hana churi krisu lolo Iya jane jane
Asiya be lila nitya Nando jayi khane
Asiya be lila nitya
Kostane rohi aso kolo dosyu gona
Kostane rohi aso kolo dosyu gona
Aage choro padhaya nilo eko jono
Aage choro padhaya
That night, the dacoits, with their weapons collected near the house where the Lord was residing, they sent a spy ahead to get proper information. The Lord was there enjoying.
Nityananda Prabhu Varo Orinna Bhodana
Meanwhile, Lord Nityananda was eating. And in all four directions, the devotees chanted the holy names of Lord Hari.
Hare Krishna! Yes.
In all four directions, the devotees chanted the holy names of Lord Hari. Lord Nityananda's companions were wild with the ecstasy of love for Lord Krishna. One devotee roared like a lion. Another made a sound like thunder. Another, tasting the nectar of ecstatic love for Lord Krishna, wept.
Yes.
Another clapped his hands and loudly laughed. Hoi, hoi,
hoi! Oto, oto, hase! Yes.
Filled with the bliss of Krishna Prem, no one slept.
No one slept.
The spy returned to the thieves. The avadut is eating. Everyone else is awake with his report.
Yes. Dasyugana bale sabe sukho khaya
Dasyugana bale sabe sukho khaya
Amarao vasi sabe
said, let them eat. When they were asleep, then we will attack.
Yes.
Happy that they would soon plunder great wealth. The thieves sat talking amongst themselves under a tree. One of them said, the gold bracelets and armlets are mine.
Yes.
Another said, I will take the pearl necklace.
Yes.
Another said, I will take the earrings.
Earrings, yeah.
And another said, I will take the gold necklace. Another said, I will take the silver anklets. their minds became absorbed in these thoughts. Nityananda's wish, the goddess of sleep came and put a veil around those thieves. At once the thieves fell asleep. They were all unconscious, bewildered by the Lord's Maya. The dawn came, still they were not awake. When the crows cawed, the thieves awakened. They did not even see the night. They were very unhappy at heart.
Yeah.
Hurriedly hid their swords and shields in the forest. Then they hurried to bathe in the Ganga. When they returned to their own place, they began to violently quarrel. One of them said, "You fell asleep first." Another said, "Well, you slept very soundly." The wicked Brahmin, who was the commander of that army of thieves, said, "Why should we quarrel? Whatever happened was all Goddess Chandi's will. One day may pass, but does that mean that all the days are gone? I think Goddess Durga bewildered us because we did not offer her worship before we left. That is the reason for all our troubles. Tonight we should all worship Goddess Durga, Chandi. We will offer her meat and wine. Then we will go to the same place again." Agreeing to this plan, the thieves, offering meat and wine, worshipped Goddess Durga.
Mahanisa sarpa loka
I love it, I love it.
Oh.
ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀರಿ.
That night, the dacoits cleaned their weapons, dressed in black clothing, and left. The night was very dark. Everyone slept. The thieves assembled. Approaching the house, the thieves saw many tall men guarding the four directions. Standing in the four directions, the armed guards again and again chanted the holy names of Lord Hari.
Hari, 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 Hari!
They were giants. They were powerful and ferocious. Their weapons were raised. The thieves saw that each of those giants had the power to kill 100 thieves.
One. One will kill 100 or something. Yes, so strong. Yes.
The giants had flower garlands around their necks and chandan, sandalwood paste, on their limbs. Again and again they chanted sankirtan of the holy names.
Haribala! Haribala!
As Lord Nityananda slept, the giants in the four directions chanted, Krishna, Krishna!
Hare Krishna! Hare Krishna! Krishna Krishna! Hare Hare! Hare Rama! Hare Rama! Rama Rama! Hare Hare!
Seeing this, the thieves became filled with wonder.
Oh. Yeah.
They left the house and sat down together. The thief said, where did these guards come from? One of them said, somehow the Avadut must have known. He brought the guards along. Again and again, I've heard from many mouths, this saintly Avadut has great knowledge.
Yes. I have a heart in fear.
He can protect himself. We all saw those guards. I don't think they were human beings. Oh. I think this Avadut has great mystic powers.
Yes.
That is why the people call him Gosai.
Gosai. Master. Yeah.
Another thief said, my brother, you are a fool. How can anyone who eats like he does and decorates himself with fancy clothes as he does be called a Gosai?
How can be called Gosai?
The Brahmin, who was the commander of that little army of thieves, said, I know the reason.
Yes.
Some big, big, important person must have come to see the Avadut. An emissary from the king must have come. The guards were his personal bodyguards.
Oh, king's bodyguards. Oh.
Those guards were all religious fanatics.
Oh.
That is why they chanted, Hari, Hari,
Hari, Hari, Hari, Hari, Hari.
All fanatics. Yes. Understand. These are all fanatics.
Religious fanatics.
Fanatics, yeah.
Ebe nahe kon poda dikani thake.
Adi Hare
Prabhu Swachhande Bihari
nice read.
The thief said, while these guards are here, we should not come. After some days, then they will leave. For now, let us go to our homes, my brothers. For 10 days, let us quietly stay at home.
Yes.
When the leader had spoken these words, the thieves returned to their homes. Meanwhile, Lord Nityananda Prabhu, the moon of Avadhuts, enjoyed pastimes as he wished. Whoever worships Lord Nityananda's feet and remembers them breaks all obstacles into pieces. Who has the power to place obstacles before Lord Nityananda? Who has the power to place obstacles before the Supreme Lord? Simply by remembering the Lord's servants, one breaks all ignorance into pieces. Ganesh and all his associates are all servants of the Supreme Lord. Shiva, who destroys the worlds, is an Amsa incarnation of the Supreme Lord. Who can bring fear to Lord Nityananda? When the Lord's Amsa incarnation, Ananta Sesh, moves, all the worlds tremble. By his own will, Lord Nityananda performed kirtan in all of Navadvipa. By his own will, he enjoyed pastimes of eating and sleeping. His every limb was decorated with priceless ornaments. He looked exactly like Rohini Kumar, Rohini's son Balaram. Lord Nityananda chewed betel nuts mixed with camphor. His gentle smile charmed the heart of every person in the world. Fearless and blissful, accompanied by a host of fearless and blissful devotees, he went everywhere.
Param Paramananda, Vaya Paramananda, Nityananda Prabhu ki aro baro jukti kori api dasyu gane aile na jukti kori api dasyu gane aile na Nityananda
takes time when they repeat it, let me sing alone. Is that all right?
Yeah.
Because it takes time.
Daive sei dine maha meghe onno karo maha ghoro nishanahi loke ro sancharo maha bhayankaro nishanahi Choro dasyu gana Daso pancho astro eko Janero kachono Pravishtha hoi lo matro Bari ravi tare Sabe hoi lo bandha keha Oh,
Another time, the thieves made a plan and came to the house where Lord Nityananda stayed. By the Lord's arrangement, there were great clouds. The darkness was blinding. The night was very fearsome. No person walked anywhere. On that very fearsome night, each thief armed himself with 5 or 10 weapons. They approached the house. Then every thief suddenly became blind.
All became blind.
No one had the power to see. They could not see anything. All the thieves were now blind. Each one of them felt his mind, intelligence, and breath were under attack. One of them fell into a ditch and was ferociously bitten by mosquitoes and leeches.
Leeches, yes.
Another, get punishment, yes.
Another fell among thorns. His every limb wounded by the thorns, he had no power to move. Another one fell into a canal. His hands and feet broken, he wept. Another burned with fever. Every thief felt terror in his heart. At that moment, the demigod Indra sent a great rainstorm to that very place. The thief bitten by mosquitoes and leeches was especially tortured by the rainstorm. Then hailstorms fell on the thieves' bodies. They could not save their lives. Everyone was plunged in an ocean of sufferings. One thief became dizzy and fell down. Forgetting who he was filled with terror. An endless rainstorm fell on the thieves. Their bodies trembled from the freezing cold. Now blind, the thieves had no power to see. Nityananda's Adi Guru. So we say, again, it's Mananda Shyan. So this is. Now blind, the thieves had no power to see. Attacked by the freezing rain, they were on the verge of death. Aware that these people were enemies of Lord Nityananda, Indra was very angry and tortured them very badly.
Tatakshane dasyu sena
Yeah.
Last limit of mercy, daya, bodhi. Huh? You understand? Say charana chintile. Aapad nahi aar, say khane kodi aparadhiyo nistar. Rakhya rakhya nityanando sri balo gopal.
Rakhya rakhya nityanando sri balo gopal.
Rakhya karo kakutuni sarko divo.
Oh,
Said, I am a great sinner. Everything I do is bad. In my heart, I wanted to rob the Supreme Lord of his wealth.
Yes.
It is he who has the power to throw me into all these calamities.
Yeah, that's his mercy. Yes.
Lord Nityananda is my only shelter. I have no other shelter. Thinking in this way, the Brahmin meditated on Lord Nityananda's feet. The calamity suddenly stopped.
Nityananda feet. Nidai pada kamala koti chandra sisi
pada. Need
Thinking in this way, the Brahmin meditated on Lord Nityananda's feet. The calamity suddenly stopped.
Yes.
At that moment, the Brahmin became free of many millions of his past offenses. The Brahmin prayed, save me, O Nityananda.
Rakya, rakya, Nityananda, Sri Bala
Gopal.
The Brahmin prayed, save me, O Nityananda, O coward boy Krishna.
Yes.
O master, O protector of all living entities, please save me.
Rakyakara, Rakyakara, Prabhu.
Yes.
A person who trips and falls to the ground takes shelter of the earth. In the same way, a person who commits offenses against you must meditate on you. Only then.
Bhumam kalita padanam bhumi revavalambanam toi jata mahaparadhanam tumeva saranam prabho.
Isn't Maharaj? Yes.
Only then can he be delivered from all his sufferings. You forgive all offenses. You are merciful to the fallen. I have killed many Brahmins and many cows. O Lord, no one is a greater offender than I am.
Yes.
Still, even the greatest sinners may find shelter in you and break to pieces the bonds that tie them to this world of birth and death. From the moment of birth, you protect the lives of the living entities. O Lord, please protect me today from these dangers. If I remain alive, I will have learned my lesson. Birth after birth, I am only your servant, O Lord. Whether I live or die, I only wish to be your servant. Hearing these words, merciful Lord Nityananda delivered all the thieves.
All the thieves. Merciful Nityananda. Huh?
Wonderfully merciful. Supremely merciful. Lord Nityananda delivered all the things. Parama Karuna Nityananda Prabhu ki
jai.
Parama Karuna Padita Pavana Nitai ki
jai.
In this way, the thieves became conscious again.
Ei matta chinti te sa kala kasyu
bhavane.
Sahara hoy lo dui, you be my darling.
Falling to the ground, he offered his dandavats. Then lifting himself up, he trembled. Again and again, the Brahman roared and thundered with ecstatic love. He was not in external consciousness. He wept, gazing at Lord Nityananda's glory. The Brahman joyfully danced. Save me, Father Nityananda.
Save me, yes.
The Brahman roared and roared, his arms raised. Seeing as the devotees became filled with wonder. How did the thief become like this?
Yeah, wonderful. The thief became like this. The thief, the god.
One devotee said, it is a trick.
It's a trick, yes.
It is a sham. Any moment he will attack us.
Yes. Don't believe me. Any moment he'll attack us. Yes.
Another devotee said, Lord Nityananda is a purifier of the fallen.
But it's a power in Indiana, look!
By his mercy, this man has become good at heart.
Yes. By his wonderful mercy, Dakar became sadhu.
Yeah.
The cat became sad by his mercy. Nitai Tanaki!
Seeing the endless symptoms of the Brahman's devotional ecstasy, Lord Nityananda.
Prabhu bole koho dijo khok to maro dito.
Prabhu bole koho dijo khok to maro dito.
Barata to maro dekhi adbhuta charito.
Barata to maro dekhi adbhuta charito.
Bide khila ki sunila krishna anubhava.
Bide khila ki sunila krishna anubhava.
Kichu chinta nahi akha pate koho sabo. Suniya Prabhura Patya Sukruti Brahmana
Suniya Prabhura Patya Sukruti Brahmana
Kahi Tena Pare Kichu Kari Krandana
Kahi Tena Pare Kichu Kari Krandana
Gharagori Jaya Pari Sakala Mane
Gharagori Jaya Pari Sakala Mane
Aase Kande Naase Gaya Apana
Yeah.
Ami sabo erai nu,
Seeing the endless symptoms of the Brahmin's devotional ecstasy, Lord Nityananda gently smiled and asked a question. The Lord said, "What has become of you? O Brahmin, please tell me. I see that your activities have become wonderful. What have you seen? What have you heard of Lord Krishna's glories? Without worrying, without trickery, please tell us everything."
Open heart, speak everything, open heart. Open heart, open your heart. Speak. Before Nityananda, excuse you, yes.
Hello. Hearing the Lord's words, the now saintly Brahmin had no power to say anything. He only wept. He fell to the ground and rolled in the courtyard. Spontaneously, he laughed, wept, danced, and sang. After some time, the Brahmin became calm. Then he said to Lord Nityananda, "My Lord, my home is in Nadia. I am a Brahmin in name only. But my actions are those of a hunter, a chandala. By always associating with wicked people, I became a violent thief. In the time of my birth, I have not been anything but that. When they see me, everyone in Navadvipa trembles in fear. There is not a sin that does not rest in my body. My Lord, when I saw your glistening ornaments, I decided to steal them. One night I came with my band of thieves to rob the treasures that decorate your graceful limbs. Lord, that night you bewildered us all. Confused by your maya, I did not know who you were. Another night, after worshiping Goddess Durga in many ways, armed with swords, daggers, and tridents, we came again. That night, we saw a great wonder. Your house was surrounded by guards. Each guard was powerful like a mad elephant. Each one wore a flower garland from his neck to his knees. As the holy name of Lord Hari was coming from every guard's mouth, you happily slept in the house. I was so simple at heart that even then I did not understand your glories. Whose guards are these? From where do they come? Thinking these thoughts, I left. After some days, I again came last night, but at once my eyes became blinded. Coming with my band of thieves, we surrounded your house. Then we all became blind, and we fell into different situations. We were bitten by mosquitoes, leeches, and scorpions. There were torrential rains and a hailstorm. We suffered badly. We had no power to move. In this way, we first suffered torture from Yamaraj. Then at the end, we became your devotees.
Yes! Danda esa anugraha eva sammata. Maharaj, danda esa anugraha eva sammata. Nidaira danda, punishment inflicted by Nidai, it is mercy, mercy, yes. Danda esa anugraha eva sammata. Krodha esa anugraha eva sammata. Is it Maharaj? Yes.
By your mercy, with unalloyed love, we meditated on your feet. Then you restored vision to our eyes. You were the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the purifier of the fallen. Simply by thinking of you, we all escaped the tortures of Yamaraj. How great is your glory! Simply by remembering you, a person breaks the bonds of ignorance and easily goes to Vaikuntha. Speaking on in this way, the Brahmin loudly wept. In this way, Lord Nityananda manifested his pastimes.
Suniya savar hoilo mahasarjya gyan suniya savar mahasarjya gyan brahmane ra pati sare kare na pranam brahmane ra pati sare kare na pranam dijo bole prabhu ebe amar bidai dijo bole prabhu ebe amar bidai e deho rakhite ar more nahi bhai.
Listening to these wonders, everyone bowed down before the Brahman. Then the Brahman said, Lord, please give me permission to depart. No longer do I wish to keep this body alive. In my heart, I desired to harm you. Therefore, my penance is that I will die by drowning myself in the Ganga.
Ganga, yes.
Hearing the Brahman's sincere words, Lord Nityananda and the devotees became pleased. Lord Nityananda said, O Brahman, you are very fortunate.
Very fortunate, you are very fortunate. Yes. Yes.
Birth after birth, you are Lord Krishna's servant.
Yeah. Lord Krishna's servant, birth after birth. Very fortunate, yes.
If you had not attained the Lord's mercy, how could all these events have taken place?
Yeah.
How could they have taken place if you were not a servant of the Lord?
Yeah.
Lord Chaitanya has ascended to this world to purify the fallen. Nityananda said, listen, Brahman, if you commit no more sins, I will accept all of your karma.
Yes. No more! No more! No more! It is no more! Yes. Don't think of in the mind also. Don't think of in the mind also. Yes. Yeah. Then I'll take all your sinful actions. Yes.
Give up violence, theft, and all misdeeds.
Yes.
Do them no more.
No more, no more, no more.
Yes.
Walk on the path of religion. Chant the holy names of Lord Hari.
Arimala!
Then you can deliver others.
Then you can deliver others. Understand? No more. Finish. Yeah. If you repeat, no mercy. Nidai, the mercy is locked now. No more mercy. Finished. Yes.
Go among the thieves and criminals.
Yes.
Bring them all to the path of religion.
Yes.
Speaking these words, Lord Nityananda took his garland.
Katha boli apongo lara mala.
Speaking these words, Lord Nityananda took the garland from his own neck and happily gave it to the Brahmin thief. There was a great sound of jai, jai. The Brahmin was now freed from material bondage.
Yes. Kaku kare dija prabhu charan.
Thank you.
Grasping Lord Nityananda's feet, the Brahmin wept and wept. His voice choked with emotion. He cried out, "O Lord Nityananda, O Master, purifier of the sinners, please give the shelter of your lotus feet to this fallen sinner. In my heart, I wished you harm. Who is more despicable than myself?" Then Lord Nityananda, who is Karuna Sindhu, an ocean of mercy, placed his lotus feet on the Brahmin's head. When his head received the mercy of Lord Nityananda's feet, the Brahmin's offenses were all broken to pieces. From then on, whenever thieves came to his door, the Brahmin guided them on the path of Dharma. He taught them to take shelter of Lord Chaitanya. Renouncing theft, violence, and all misdeeds, all the thieves became very saintly. After associating with the Brahmin, they all chanted the holy names of Lord Hari hundreds of thousands of times.
Haribala, Haribala!
They all became expert in devotional service to Lord Vishnu. Wild with love for Lord Krishna, Lord Nityananda always sang Lord Krishna's holy names. In this way, Lord Nityananda was an ocean of mercy. In no other incarnation did the Supreme Lord act in such a way.
Nityananda Parama Kautike, Nityananda Parama Kautike, Nityananda Parama Kautike, Nityananda Parama Kautike,
In none of the previous incarnations was the Supreme Lord so compassionate as Lord Nityananda. Lord Nityananda gives liberation and love of God instantly to the conditioned souls. Hence, if anyone, even an elevated Brahmin, disregards Lord Nityananda, then such a person is degraded to the level of dacoits and murderers.
Yes.
The ecstatic symptoms of love of Godhead are so intensely desired by the master yogis who want to experience crying, shivering, horripilation, and other such spiritual emotions are now made easily available even to the rogues and thieves by the wonderful divine potency of Lord Nityananda. Therefore, all of you, please worship such a merciful Lord Nityananda. By his grace, one can attain the shelter of Lord Gaurachandra. One who hears Lord Nityananda's pastimes will indeed reach Lord Chaitanya. And one who hears properly this story of the deliverance of the dacoits is assured to see face to face both Lord Nityananda and Lord Chaitanya.
परम करुण पहुंदुई जन ताई गौर चंद्र
ghore bhai tribhuvane nahi ye mando dayalo data
re ghore bhai tribhuvane nahi ye mando dayalo data
os paathi dure asanu bhidore suni jaro pode na hilo so
sare mahina roye paria te pade na hilo ata
apna karma gaye samana kahe lo dhana maso
apna karma gaye samana kahe lo dhana ata
apna
Oh,